The president never really clicked with his second national security advisor, H.R. McMaster, stylistically or on policy grounds. The White House had spent much of the past week telling reporters that H.R. McMaster was safe and not going anywhere for the foreseeable future. But last night, H.R. McMaster was out. John Bolton is in. John Bolton, as you say, the former U.N. ambassador, also Fox News contributor. Here's the statement from the president of the United States last night on H.R. McMaster. The president saying McMaster has served his country with distinction for more than 30 years. He has won many battles, and his bravery and toughness are legendary. General McMaster's leadership of the National Security Council staff has helped my administration accomplish great things to bolster America's national security. H.R. McMaster put out a statement saying, after 34 years of service to our nation, I am requesting retirement from the U.S. Army effective this summer, after which I will leave public service. Throughout my career, it has been my greatest privilege to serve alongside extraordinary service members and dedicated civilians. I'm thankful to President Donald J. Trump for the opportunity to serve him and our nation as National Security Advisor. That's interesting because it indicates that H.R. McMaster is retiring from the Army altogether. There had been some speculation that the president, in order to move him out easily, would give him a fourth star. H.R. McMaster is a three-star general, and give him a promotion effectively within the Army. That's clearly not happening here, so we'll have to figure out exactly why that plan didn't come to fruition. But who is John Bolton, the man who will now serve as President Trump's third national security advisor? Well, as we said, he's a former U.S. ambassador to the United Nations. He's a senior fellow at the Conservative American Enterprise Institute, and he's a Fox News contributor. He's seen as very hawkish on a number of issues, including on North Korea. He recently wrote an op-ed suggesting that the people who were arguing against a preemptive strike in North Korea were, in fact, simply wrong, and that the United States had a legal basis to go in as a first strike against North Korea because of the threat of their nuclear weapons. So that's seen as a hawkish turn in the National Security Advisor's post.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.